Solana. I'm 21, and I'm a costume designer. When I was a little bit younger, like pre-high school, I was always watching films, and I noticed that there was something about the costumes that told a separate story, and that's what kind of attracted me into paying more attention to fashion. And so I'm just always kind of inspired by finding things in the research and finding things in parts of history, because I think they have their own value and they have their own story to tell as well. I did a traditional Spanish folkwear for actually my family. It was a commission from my aunt. So that was one of the looks that I did for her for the sort of president's reception. I have another piece that I did, which is like my doublet. It's one of my favorites. And then I have my dip dye jacket and corset stamp work that you can roll out, which I actually have worked with. So it's like once you get the leather wet, you're able to roll the stamps into it and it like stencils the pattern in. Pattern books, different like artistic books, like my roommate has Savage Beauty, which is always gorgeous. I had already been very interested in drag and sort of the costume and looks that came out of it. So coming to Los Angeles, I knew of some of these performers, especially in Dragula, which is a competition for drag performers that kind of embodies more horror and filth and also a little bit of glamour. And a lot of the Dragula Season 1 girls were locals in LA, so it was very easy to just kind of casually meet them and get to know them. I've continued going because supporting local artists kind of gives you, or just getting to work with other artists in general gives you an inspiration, gives you like a fuel to keep going too. Kind of hard to describe. Some of the artists that I've worked with, like Tito Soto and Bitch Pudding a lot, have just kind of changed how I see things too. It kind of goes along the lines of when you work with someone else's aesthetic, you see design elements from a different perspective entirely. Queerness to me means like somewhat breaking the boundaries at every turn. When I first had the word and the identity like queer described to me, it was something that does, where there are several boxes to check off, it is the identity that does not fit within any of them. Queer was somewhat the empowered other, instead of being labeled as something that's different, it's empowering that and making that a feeling of identity and security, I guess. And knowing that you're unique in that sense. In my craft, it's kind of been similar because I, as a designer, present a specific experience or a specific aesthetic to my designs, and with my skill, just like with any other designer, it comes out in a different way than it would with anyone else. And I think presenting designs that have something different or have something new to offer, they start new conversations, is a way that queerness sort of inspires my art. Within the community, there's also a continuous movement of change, and just like with fashion, season after season, there's new things to be found and new things to be created, and queerness really kind of embodies that sector of design where it's not just a commercial version, it's not, you know, simply marketable, it's unique and it's special. I think one of the biggest lessons that has continued throughout like my schooling, throughout my professional experience, is that like you gotta roll with punches. Throughout my entire school year and throughout this past 6 months, it's like little things when you're working with clients or when you're working on the set will change at any given moment, and you have to know how to kind of continue on and what options you have from there. I think a lot of that is also in knowing that when you fail, you have to roll back and you have to come back from it. Yeah, I think that's probably the thing that keeps me going.